Hello there, this is Delight Channel. I'm happy to have you here once again this week, and I hope you are happy to be here. We've been talking over the last couple of weeks about preparation for retirement. And last week, I spent time focusing on the cognitive preparation. And I hope you learned a thing or two from that video, and I hope you are ready to continue the journey once again this week. This week, we are taking a step further into the second umbrella of preparation. Remember, I mentioned three umbrellas already. Number one is the cognitive preparation, which we took last week. This week, we start our conversation on behavioral preparation. And once we're done with behavioral preparation, we will then go to the one that is more common, which has to do with the financial preparation. So, when I say behavioral preparation, what exactly am I talking about? I'm saying, how does the cognitive preparation manifest into behavior? Behaviors are actions and responses that we exhibit and produce, usually and almost always as a result of our mental or emotional state. That's behavior. Visible actions, okay? Things that can be seen in the way we think, in the way we talk, in the way we act. So the way we think affects the way we talk, the way we think affects the way we act, and affects the way we engage the world around us. And when it comes to the concept of retirement, there is a thing or two you need to learn about your behavioral preparation. Let me try and find the hook between the cognitive and the behavioral. And forgive me if I have to be a bit long-winded or break this into two or three videos. Now, remember last week I said how you think about yourself and how your career will go affects how ready you are for retirement. So, let me dimension this along a few lines so that it is easy to properly digest. The first element under the behavioral preparation is how you relate with yourself. The second is, how do you relate with your family, immediate and extended? The third is, how do you relate with your colleagues or the people you meet as a result of your work life? And the fourth is how you relate with the society. So it can be the estate in which you live, it can be the church in which you worship, it can be the mosque in which you worship, it can be any club to which you belong. How do you relate with the people you meet there? I repeat again, the process starts from the cognitive, but unfortunately, we can't see your thought. The only thing we can see are the behavior that you put forward. So, as we speak about behavior, please remember that if you are going to bring forward or bring forth those required behavior, you must go back to the thought process and fix the thought process so that you can have the right behavior. Now, let's run quickly through the first one, your relationship with yourself. Remember, like I mentioned last week, you will not always be this strong, you will not always be this healthy, you will not always be this involved, you will not always be this relevant, you will not always be this powerful. Therefore, with yourself, you must learn to relate with understanding and with acceptance. The rule of the relationship with yourself, not just for retirement, but through life, is to relate with yourself from a point of understanding and from a point of acceptance. As a matter of, by way of specifics, if you realize that you will not always be this strong, it means that as you hit retirement and you see your physical strength disappearing or weakening, you will relate with yourself with acceptance to come to terms with it that, yes, this comes with old age. I mean, sometimes something as basic as trying to punish a child or flog a child can cause a man to begin to pant and be looking for breath. That's the physical requirement. So that acceptance helps you to relate with yourself in a manner that you are not beating yourself up because you can't remember something as quickly as you used to, because you cannot recollect it, because you seem not to be clear about facts anymore, or you are now slow in terms of how you handle certain things. It's natural. It's normal. There's very little you can do about it. So with yourself, you must learn how to laugh at yourself and joke about it. Don't get so uptight. Don't get so irritable. Don't get so grouchy. Don't get so touchy that because you are not accepting yourself, you become a hot button that everybody begins to avoid. That makes it more complicated. So, in terms of behavior, you must accept yourself. You've forgotten something, learn to laugh about it. I was in a class recently, and one of my profs, Professor Kaegbu, I hope I pronounced it very well, came up and was talking about how it's natural as you age, science has shown your brain size starts to shrink. You are not dead, but the mass begins to wither because they are made of nerves and nerve cells, and the aging process, the rate of replication is not as fast as it was when you were younger. So it's natural, laugh about it, accept yourself, deal with it, don't make it a big deal, don't turn it into a point of disagreement with yourself, and then you begin to look at yourself as being less than who you are. It's only natural. It comes with the territory and is part of growing up. That's number one. Number two is how you behave towards your family. The very direct recipient of how you behave to yourself is your family. Are you now accepting yourself to the point that it can be a matter of joke and everybody can laugh about it, and therefore they are willing and quick to help you? And therefore, you are also willing and quick to ask for help. When you were much younger, you could lift 50 kg, 250 kg kegs on both hands up the staircase. Now, you want to carry a small bowl of water, you need help. You should be happy to ask for the help. It affects, your accepting yourself affects how you relate with your family. It means that when you are now no longer running out at 7:30 or 6 o'clock, whatever time, and coming back very late, you're accepting yourself makes it now easy for you to relate with your family. You behave with them. You behave to them with love. You behave towards them with friendliness. When you forget something, you are open to it. When you need help, you can ask. When they need help from you, you are also willing to give, and you are not saying, when I was walking, will you dare come forward and ask me to help you look after this or drive you there? You're accepting yourself is central to how you behave towards the family. Because if you have a good behavior to yourself, you have a good behavior towards your family, your retirement age becomes a lot more tolerable. That behavioral part of this preparation is something you need to take serious note of. Otherwise, if you still want to be the man of the house, giving all the instructions and commanding everyone, when you need help, you won't be humble enough to accept. When you need help, you will not be humble enough to ask. And when you are even forced to ask for the help, the arrogance and the pride will stop you from enjoying it and making the best of the situation. And I think I had to stop there, so I don't go too long-winded today. But we still have some more to cover as touching your behavioral preparation. And if you want to know what we are going to talk about, it means you have to be here next week. Because by God's grace, we will be here to serve you the next edition, hot and steamy. And I hope you will not miss it. Tell your friends, we are sharing very foundational things here. And I hope you are finding it relevant. Until then, T-Mac is my name, Delight is the channel, and don't ever forget that all we are trying to do here is what? Make a little difference. I hope to see you next time. Bye.